I want to give you a brief insight into the evilness. I want you to have a face for evil because this is one of the faces of evil that you should be able to recognize. And I want you to listen to what's being said because I'm going to share something with you that should open your eyes to the reality of where we are right now. I pray that everybody would accept Jesus Christ of the Bible. The Bible says the divine expression that is Christ, which is up. The divine expression that is Christ is up. That's why it says, when the Son of Man is lifted up, you'll know that I am He. When I turn the version upside down, it's a dead sheep. What am I doing, really? Huh. I'm inverting something so I see the truth. I want to see the truth, the Jesus of the Bible, invert the whole world. And you'll see the one that created all things, even Elohim. There you go. Okay. Now, watch this.
Is our imagination. We can cooperate flexibly with countless numbers of strangers because we alone, of all the animals on the planet, can create and believe fictions, fictional stories. And as long as everybody believes in the same fiction, everybody obeys and follows the same rules, the same norms, the same values. All other animals use their communication system only to describe reality. A chimpanzee may say, "Look, there is a lion, let's run away." Or, "Look, there is a banana tree over there, let's go and get bananas." Humans, in contrast, use their language not merely to describe reality, but also to create new realities, fictional realities. A human can say, "Look, there is a God above the clouds. And if you don't do what I tell you to do, after you die, God will punish you and send you to hell. And if you all believe these stories that I have invented, then you will follow the same norms and laws and values, and you can cooperate." This is something only humans can do. You can never convince a chimpanzee to give you a banana by promising him that after you die, you'll go to chimpanzee heaven. And you'll receive lots and lots of bananas for your good deeds. So now give me this banana. No chimpanzee will ever believe such a story. Only humans believe such stories, which is why we control the world, whereas the chimpanzees are locked up in zoos and research laboratories. Now, you may find it acceptable that, yes, in the religious field, humans cooperate by believing in the same fictions. Millions of people come together to build a cathedral or a mosque or fight on a crusade or in a jihad because they all believe in the same stories about God and heaven and hell. But what I want to emphasize is that exactly the same mechanism underlies all other forms of mass-scale human cooperation, not only in the religious field. Take, for example, the legal field. Most legal systems today in the world are based on a belief in human rights. But what are human rights? Human rights, just like God and heaven, are just a story that we've invented. They are not an objective reality. They are not some biological fact about Homo sapiens. Take a human being, cut him open, look inside, you will find the heart, the kidneys, neurons, hormones, DNA. But you won't find any rights. The only place you find rights is in the stories that we have invented and spread around over the last few centuries.
Okay, so if you can't read between the lines and what that sick, twisted, evil man is saying, it's like you don't have any rights. Those are things that you've made up in your own mind. You're animals. This idea that there's a God in heaven is your own fictional belief. Now, so you want to see the face of evil? Look at that. Now, that's Klaus Schwab's little boy right there. And I want to tie all this together for you because I see clearly what's coming. I've known what's coming since the night I got saved. The Lord told me there was a fire coming to warn everybody to turn back to Him with their whole heart so they can escape the horrors of what's coming on this world. Now, you can either believe that I am that messenger or tell me to piss off. I don't care. But I have a litany of data that should substantiate everything I say. And then I go online and I produce this information and I show you the Vatican's a snake, image of the Virgin's dead sheep, largest altar in the world is also a dead sheep. I have people walking up to me and handing me pictures of me with a dead sheep on the picture they drew of me, which totally suggests that a serpent race is hunting me. Otherwise, why would someone hand me a picture of a dead sheep hidden behind my ear or on my forehead with a serpent eating me, especially when the largest church in the world is hidden in plain sight as a serpent eating a sheep? Okay, it's a no-brainer. You know, it's fascinating to me. And then I see people that claim they're Christians, and they come on and they say, how dare you? No Christian would ever brag about laying hands on people and them getting well. The Bible says we're supposed to brag about the things that the Lord has done. And by the way, I just want the world to know, in case I haven't done it, yeah, recently, I give all the glory to God. I'm not worthy to unlatch his sandals, as the case may be. And I try and be very vocal about the fact that what I'm doing is not me. It's the Lord using me, because I'm nothing. He's the one doing all of it, just like Brandon's dad, who was in a coma. The guy's in a coma. The Lord told me to go to his house and whisper into his ear, because I live, you will live also. He told me to go over there and trust him and do it. I want you to know the God that I serve is the God that sends a person to a house to whisper in some guy's ear that's in a coma, that's been in a coma for over 24 hours. And he said that everyone would know that he heard me. I mean, okay, granted, yeah, it takes a lot of faith to go over and do that, because if you whisper into his ear and nothing happens, then what does everybody think about you, since you just told everyone you'll all know he heard me? Well, obviously, maybe God didn't send you over. But if I told everybody before I went that this is what the Lord said to do, which is what I did, because that shows my faith that the Lord is the one telling me. And I said, the Lord said, if I go over there and whisper into his ear, everyone will know that he heard me, meaning Brandon's dad. And when I whispered into Brandon's dad's ear, because I live, you will live also, the people that were in the room started screaming, and I don't know if it was excitement or terror or a combination thereof, because his eyes opened up. And as soon as I whispered, because I live, you will live also, a person in a coma, their eyes opened wide up, and everybody in the room, oh my God, oh my God, oh, his eyes opened. It was just like mayhem. And then I got away from him, and I looked at them, and his eyes opened again, and the Lord said everyone would know. The reason I tell you these stories is so you can know that the person that's speaking to you has documented proof and evidence. I just go to the Collect Policy, all over YouTube, all over different platforms, that these things have happened. And the Bible says these things will accompany those that the Lord God sends out. So if that makes someone mad that I'm sharing that with you, who do they serve? See, because I have people leaving comments, how dare you tell, like, you go around and lay hands on people. We're supposed to brag about the things the Lord has done. So that's what the Lord has done. He's used me to go lay hands on people that are blind and they see. And he's the one that used me to expose the Vatican's a snake. So it's the Lord that does it. I'm just the point man, the conduit. So there you go. So if that offends somebody, well, you're looking kind of snaky to me. I'm just saying, looking kind of snaky to Johnny. Okay, so that shouldn't offend you. You should be like, praise God, man. That's so cool. Okay, now getting back to what I'm showing you right now. This is Noah Harari. This is Klaus Schwab's right-hand man. Well, y'all know before everybody got the stabber jabber, right? I was, my channel on this platform was humming. There was probably a couple hundred million views worldwide with my views mirrored views. And then I touched on a really touchy subject. It was about the stabber jabber everybody was getting. And I mentioned that, you know, it was what's called mRNA, which changes your DNA forever. Changes your DNA. So if you're a human and you add mRNA to you, then from that point on, your DNA has a change in it. What's really fascinating, when I went and looked at all the stuff, what transpired, and then all of a sudden, they were going back several years to find things I'd done wrong on YouTube so they could get rid of me. Anyway, that's what happened. Yeah. So anyway, we're not going to talk about mRNA. It's RPTR. You know what? Y'all can go check it out all you want, but I just want to share. Let's just do a search. Let's see. I'm going to do a real quick search. Hang on one sec. Okay, so this is very interesting. I'm just going to do this. Right? Watch this. Just type those in to your search. Okay, so you see that? Those are letters. Okay, now I'm going to go back and do it again so it populates. Watch. Just watch. Okay, so see that? You see that? RPTR. I'm just going to go to Wikipedia real quick. And these guys maybe can. Okay, so read this out loud. Of are also known as okay, see that right there? It's an adapter protein that is by the and you see that? That's short for that, okay? Okay, now and there's that. Remember how I show you everything is like they have their V and we have our V, right? Hang on one stack. Signal transducing. Does that look like the letter V a little bit to you guys? Just anyway, yeah, but at that point, things got really weird. Anyway, so now we're just going to leave that on the shelf. I'll let you guys go just do a little digging. Go back, see maybe the collect files, see my videos around those times. But that's what was swatting the hornet's nest. That right there, known as that, right there. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so it's a signal transducing. You know what signal transducing means? That means it sends signals through your system, you know, like signal transduction. You know, like, hey, are you there? Hey, yeah, I'm here. Hey, can you hear me? Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah, the signal's coming through. We're transducing a signal. Wonder what signal that is. Anyway, let me show you. Y'all remember the guy that, y'all remember when little Naz was pregnant because he said he was having a baby? Well, you know that reptilian race is birthing right now, right? Y'all know that? Or no? Have y'all noticed? Have y'all seen what's going on in governments all over the world, the injustice, how they don't care about you, kind of like you're just animals, you know, that believe some fiction of some god in the sky. It's nonsense. You know, like that guy, Noah Harari, keeps telling everybody, you're just hackable animals. That's what Noah says. You're just a hackable animal. So the idea that you have human rights, those are constructs made up by you. You don't have any human rights, according to these guys. Now, watch, someone will take what I just said and they'll adulterate it. And whoever you are that does it, I would imagine it's going to be a hot future for you. Anyway, but you'll do it anyway. Okay, let's get back. Just remember what this guy said, okay? Okay, please listen for just a little while to this again, please, because I'm going to play something else you did not hear. It's very important. I want you to understand the mindset of what I'm about to show you.
That might interest chimpanzees. Now, cooperation is, of course, not always nice. All the horrible things humans have been doing throughout history, and we have been doing some very horrible things, all those things are also based on large-scale cooperation. Prisons are a system of cooperation, slaughterhouses are a system of cooperation, concentration camps are a system of cooperation. Chimpanzees don't have slaughterhouses and prisons and concentration camps. Now, suppose I've managed to convince you, perhaps, that yes, we control the world because we can cooperate flexibly in large numbers. The next question that immediately arises in the mind of inquisitive listener is how exactly do we do it? What enables us, alone of all the animals, to cooperate in such a way? The answer is our imagination. We can cooperate flexibly with countless numbers of strangers because we alone, of all the animals on the planet, can create and believe fictions, fictional stories. And as long as everybody believes in the same fiction, everybody obeys and follows the same rules, the same norms, the same values. All other animals use their communication system only to describe reality. A chimpanzee may say, look, there is a lion, let's run away. Or look, there is a banana tree over there, let's go and get bananas. Humans, in contrast, use their language not merely to describe reality, but also to create new realities, fictional realities. A human can say, look, there is a God above the clouds, and if you don't do what I tell you to do, after you die, God will punish you and send you to hell. And if you all believe these stories that I have invented, then you will follow the same norms and laws and values, and you can cooperate. This is something only humans can do. You can never convince a chimpanzee to give you a banana by promising him that after you die, you'll go to chimpanzee heaven and you'll receive lots and lots of bananas for your good deeds. So now give me this banana. No chimpanzee will ever believe such a story. Only humans believe such stories, which is why we control the world, whereas the chimpanzees are locked up in zoos and research laboratories. Now, you may find it acceptable that, yes, in the religious field, humans cooperate by believing in the same fictions. Millions of people come together to build a cathedral or a mosque or fight on a crusade or in a jihad because they all believe in the same stories about God and heaven and hell. But what I want to emphasize is that exactly the same mechanism underlies all other forms of mass-scale human cooperation, not only in the religious field. Take, for example, the legal field. Most legal systems today in the world are based on a belief in human rights.
Okay, I'm going to stop him right there. So if you can read between the lines and the obviousness, first of all, you spew out a bunch of dichotomous nonsense about humans and chimpanzees as if they're comparable. You obviously left out the fact that we are different from all of them because we have an eternal soul. But remember, he's telling you that's a fictional story, and that people that believe these fictional stories can come together and build a cathedral so they can believe the fictional story together. But here you go, Noah. Why'd they built it in the shape of a snake wearing a crown hidden in plain sight, dipstick? Okay, so now, Noah, your whole thing's done. You're done. So this guy that's sitting there telling you that and by the way, if you continue to watch, he says this idea that you have some soul that goes on after this, he goes, this is fiction. So he's telling you it's all fiction because Noah Harari says so. Well, I watched an interview with him, and he was very upset that it took it till he was 21 to find out he was gay. He said it. He was upset because the world constructs and how the world tells you what you're supposed to be, and how he felt like he wasted a lot of time not knowing that he was gay until he was 21. Okay, well, that sounds like you don't see chimpanzees, I don't think, and lions, boy lions going out and doing the naughty together. It's just something you don't see, but apparently Noah forgets to leave out some crucial details. The male chimpanzees pretty much stick to the female chimpanzees, and he left that part out too, but he leaves a lot of stuff out. But the point that's important to understand is he's dehumanizing everybody to you're an animal. He wants to make sure before he's done with this little speech that you know you're an animal and that all your belief systems are fictional stories. But he leaves out crucial details because he doesn't know him, because he is the face of evil. He's one of the faces of evil. And the idea that you don't have a soul because he says so is like one of the most ludicrous, arrogant things I've ever heard a person say. But you know who he's right-hand boy of, Klaus Schwab. Well, you know, they led the whole charge with the whole everybody has to get a stabber jabber. Otherwise, you're not going to be okay, and you're a threat to the whole world if you don't go get one of those stabber jabbers. Remember, at first, all the people that were on the front lines were heroes. God bless them. But then when they were forced into getting the stabber jabber themselves, then they were considered, oh, you losers, how dare you put everyone at risk? Because my body, my choice, right? But not anymore, because they say so, remember? So they also just said, or he, you know, with obviously the backing of the WEF and their boys, he said that all these are fictional stories, and the idea that you have any human rights is also a fictional story. So they just told you that you don't have any human rights, so they could care less what you think. There you go. So it's a no-brainer. Now I've set the stage for what I want to show you. Okay, this was all to get the stage set to show you what I wanted to show you. How many of y'all have seen me draw this whole thing in? Y'all know what that is? Y'all know what that whole thing is? That's a presidential portrait. The guy in it turns into the serpent in the garden. He also, one side of his head is a T-Rex. The other side's a dead sheep. Remember he said on The View, oh, we all have a reptilian part of our brain. Well, why would Whoopi Goldberg have to say, I ask you now, who are we? What are we? He's like, well, we're all tied together because reptiles and sheep are tied together. Demons and angels tied together within a host body. So he says, well, you know, we're all tied together and our futures are all kind of interlinked. And, you know, what's still true today is we have a reptilian side of our brain. I mean, it's like, what? He's exactly right. Our futures are tied together. And there is a reptilian part and there is a sheep part. One consciousness answers to the pit. The other consciousness answers to God. But that's the predicament that we're all in. And now they're rolling out, you know, the end of it all. So here's the end game, right? So they wanted to make sure everyone got your little stabber jabber. I showed you a little thing when I started this. You should go check it out. RPTOR. It's short for RAPTOR. Why didn't they just leave the A in there? Maybe because it'd be a little too obvious for you. Why are you putting something that's got lizard in it in everybody? Anyway, it's just a thought. It's like, okay. And now they're going for X, you know, Twitter. They're going to try and take Twitter down now, guaranteed, because too many people are coming together and seeing, their eyes are opening, guys, and they're realizing where this is all going. But there's no stopping it. That's why I'm trying to get everybody on the turn the world upside down, see the truth, accept the truth. Let Christ take your sins for you, and let Noah Harari go on his little fictional trip to the pit. Okay, so anyway, so that's what I'm trying to do. Now, here we go. This guy's already showed his whole deck of cards. Let me show you this. This guy right here, this is a makeup that was done by the girl that did Little Nas. Little Nas, when he said he was pregnant, you know, he had the big bump, the baby bump, and he was doing some vids. He apparently, from what I understand, his makeup artist did this guy, and this guy just went walking down the street just to get people's reaction. But I believe it was Little Nas's makeup artist. Don't quote me on that. That's what I've been made to understand. But either way, it doesn't matter who did his makeup. I want you to listen to what he says, because he's not joking. Here you go.
With, it was weird and smelled like beef tacos. He was right.
Some of us are reptiles. That guy you... Well, I think it's finally safe to say. That guy you were on the train with, it was weird and smelled like beef tacos. He was right. Some of us are reptiles. That guy, you went to that convenience store down in the south, and he said,
I swear to God, them reptiles is real, I seen them.
He was also right. I'm here, baby. I ain't going nowhere.
Okay, so there you go. Now, I don't know if you guys know about so very briefly, you know, there's a series that's come out, or the movie, whatever, the Netflix that the Obamas are involved in, called Leaving the World Behind. Did you know, I mean, I've shown you the presidential portrait. There's a whole folder. I drew in all every leaf. There's, I love you in Christ, but I don't care what anybody in the world says. The presidential portrait was done by Kehinde Wiley. He's gay, and he openly says he put semen in his paintings to take little jabs at masculinity, which is male energy. That's what he said, and I've shown you the video clips. So Kehinde Wiley, the guy that did the presidential portrait, said in an interview that, yes, I put semen in my sperm in my painting, taking masculinity down to its most basic element to take little jabs at masculinity. Well, it's no wonder he's got a sperm right there on Obama's forehead, and it's the fang of a serpent. A serpent's bite is sperm. There you go. It's perfect. That shows that the serpent race impregnated Eve first. So, and that was Satan's spirit going in Eve in the form of a sperm. And then Adam impregnated her, and she had heteropaternal superfecundation twins. And the Lord's let me prove it all day long. I mean, it's a no-brainer now. We're in a twin system. It's good and evil, and that's the system. Okay, now, here we go. Let's just get this out on the table. Obama's involvement in the Leave the World Behind explained. Leave the World Behind, Netflix news disaster thriller, taking viewers by storm. That's cryptic anyway. Disaster taking viewers by storm. It's currently number one film in streaming platforms, starring blah, blah, blah. It involves these actors and his unique connection to the Obamas is no conspiracy theory. So blah, blah, blah. If you go and you read about it, that Barack Obama had direct contact with the makers of the film and input into the production of the film. So he wasn't just passively on the sideline with nothing to do about it. So a guy that in his presidential portrait is a reptile, he's a serpent in the garden, and he's a T-Rex, tyrant lizard king, which would suggest that he's the tyrant lizard king in the flesh. Then he is the one that's involved with the Netflix production of Leave the World Behind. So that would suggest that if he's got influence in it, that his influence should be recognizable. Let me show you what I see. Let me show you the recognizable parts that I believe you should see. Let's go down here and let's look at this. Here's a good one. This Dave the Wave saw this, and let me show you this. So whenever you show, you know, people that are the actors, Julia Roberts, Marshala Ali, Mahershala Ali, Ethan Hawke, Maya La, okay. But look right here. Look how they line this up. I want you to look how they line that up. See it? Isn't that convenient that it all lines up to be Baal? You see it? Look right here. Here it is. B-A-A-L. Look how they lined it up with just barely any plausible deniability, please. It's Baal. I mean, why is it... It looks like everything's coming down like out of heaven, and then here's your deer. I mean, you know, everything I've seen since the Lord employed me to do this is that we're being hunted through the host body system. There's a clothing line called For Hunted. I've shown you Hunted for Dinner, Hunted for Dinner. So they're hunting us. We're the sheep, they're the serpents, and they hunt us through the host body system. When you turn the world upside down, then you can see them. That's why when you turn the virgin upside down, it's a dead sheep, and then I can see the other race of beings is up to something. And then the Lord's given me so much data, 70,000 images, I don't know how many links, but it's a no-brainer. The Vatican's a snake, end of story. Vatican's eating is eating a big sheep made up of angels, so the serpent eats angels. End of story. 350, Anna Crino, the Lord made me an end-time harbinger. Anyone that doesn't believe it, I love you in Christ, don't care. You not believing it doesn't make anything not true either. And anyone saying that we are not Elohim. All you've done is go completely against the scriptures, because the scriptures say in Psalm 82, have I not said you are gods? The word for gods is Elohim. Have I not said, I have said ye are, not have I not said, I have said ye are gods, Elohim. Psalm 82, I think verse 6, maybe verse 4. So if you go to John 10:34, Jesus reiterates that and tells the Jews, hey, don't your own scriptures say, I have said ye are God's Elohim? So no one can argue with it. Otherwise, you're telling me the word of God is wrong, and the word of God's not wrong. That's why Jesus said in John 10:34 and 10:35, have I not said ye are gods? Do not your own scripture say, I have said ye are gods? And if the word of God came unto them that are called gods, and the scriptures cannot be broken. So it's wrapped up. It's a done deal. Ye are Elohim. In Genesis 1, 26, 27, Elohim said, let us create man in our vain show, illusion, representative figure, especially an idol. Elohim said that, not El, the Almighty God, Elohim. But El created Elohim. So those are the ones that are in trouble for doing the big no-no. Okay, now, it's all been solved. Do you see the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti? Did y'all watch the Lord God take hold of a servant and draw in a hieroglyph that's 1,300 years before Christ? Literally just draw it all in, show you the shifting shadows, that it's a serpent race eating a sheep race. Do you think anybody could do that? Okay, so when someone says you're bragging about it, no, I'm bragging about what the Lord did. The Lord used me to do it. I'm a servant of the Most High, so I don't really care what people think. I don't care. Can sit there and say what they want all day long. It doesn't change anything. There's a serpent race eating a sheep race. A serpent race are demons. The sheep race are the angels. Angel and a demon caught in a host body. Male and female energy. Male is from heaven, our Father who art in heaven. Female energy is from the pit. Started the host body system, Parthenogenesis. Vatican and the building next to it are snakes. End of story. It's stupid obvious now. And if people don't get it, I love you in Christ. My days of worrying about getting those people on the boat, God have mercy on them. But I'm here to minister to my brothers and sisters. I'm here to watch out for the sheep. I'm still here as a shepherd for the sheep. And I'm here to help you guys out. Oh, you know what? Speaking of shepherd for the sheep, at the end of this video, if anyone wants to help this ministry out, now would be a great time. We had some stuff come up over Christmas. And we have one of our... The person that was kidnapped, he's got some stuff coming up, and we need to help him. I need to help him out. He's got some big bills that are coming up, and he's got to take care of them, or the other side will try and put him in jail. And so I'm not going to let that happen. So Richard Montblue could use your help, and I could use your help helping him, because the other side of that equation will have the opportunity to try and lock him up in jail. So anyway, I told him not to worry about it. We'll take care of it. We'll make it happen. He is working on his testimony on everything that happened so everybody can know all the details. He's been working on it for a while. But anyway, we've gotten to a point where we need to step up and make sure that they don't try and lock him up and get him in the position where they want him. Okay, now, sorry, just hit my brain. Okay, back to this. Okay, so leave the world behind. Why would the Obamas take part in this? I mean, let's see. Well, he's right there in that giant poster. He's a T-Rex. He's also the serpent in the garden in his presidential portrait. Those are things that are already established. The name Light Barack Obama means lightning from heaven. Luke 10:18 says, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Barack is lightning from the heavens. Obama. I'm just saying. These are facts. I did a long video called The Sun Rising in the West. It was on my other channel. Probably had 8 million views before they nailed it. But it's The Sun Rising in the West, which is his logo for his presidency. The Mahdi, the coming of the Islamic Jihad leader, the one that will lead Islam in the final war, the last war. The coming of the Mahdi shall be preceded by the sun rising from the place of its setting. That's written in the Hadith. And so that's in the video. It shows you. Why is his logo exactly what's written in the Hadith? The sun rising over the stripes of the American flag is his logo. Joe Biden, his logo is the sun fully risen over the three stripes of the American flag. And we know Obama is the one telling Joe Biden what to do. So that suggests that the sun is fully risen and he's the one calling the shots now. And it looks like he's the one that's been running everything. I have a really great little video clip of Karine Jean-Pierre. I want to play it for you, but I'm afraid if I play it for you, they'll try and nail it. So what I'm going to do is I want to put a little video in right now. I'm going to put it as the first thing right when you turn on my video. Let me show you where to go. Watch. So when you turn on my video, you'll see right here. You'll see right here in the description. You will see a link to Jean-Pierre, you know, the press secretary, assuring us that Obama's not the one running things. But I don't want to put it in here because, you know, it's just like the RPTOR. Ooh, I left out that A. It's Raptor. All right. So, all right, jumping around a little bit, but here we go. Ready? Okay, so we know who this guy is right here. He's a real douche. Okay, Nacho Libre language there. So this guy's convinced everybody that it's all fiction and that your soul, that's all fiction. Okay, so now I'm going to jump back to Noah Harari, so please listen.
Thank you. Wow. Yuval, you have a new book out. After Sapiens, you wrote another one, and it's out in Hebrew, but not yet translated into
I'm working on the translation.
In the book, if I understand it correctly, you argue that actually the amazing breakthrough that we are experiencing right now not only will potentially make our life better, but they will create, and I quote you, new classes and new class struggles, just as the Industrial Revolution did. Can you elaborate for us?
Yes, in the Industrial Revolution, we saw the creation of a new class of the urban proletariat. And much of the political and social history of the last 200 years involved what to do with this class and the new problems and opportunities. Now, we see the creation of a new massive class of useless people. As computers become better and better in more and more fields, there is a distinct possibility that computers will outperform us in most tasks and will make humans redundant. And then the big political and economic question of the 21st century will be, what do we need humans for? Or at least, what do we need so many humans for?
Do you have an answer in the book?
At present, the best guess we have is keep them happy with drugs and computer games. But this
Okay, so now, I want you to look at this guy. I mean, I want you to just take a moment to realize what he's already told you. So he's Klaus Schwab's right-hand little boy that's out there telling you there is no God. He's already told you it's all fiction. If you think there's some God, you have to answer to. So then he's also telling you that human rights. So that means if you think they care about what you are, or who you are, or your soul, you're a lunatic. These people don't, you're an animal. He said you are hackable animals. That's what he said. And this idea that there's some God in heaven is nonsense. So he said those words. Now, remember, they rolled out this stab and jab thing for everybody, right? And we all found out it was a bunch of nonsense. And the people that refused to get it were demonized. They were said, oh, they're going to be the reason everybody dies. Oh, yeah, and they tried to shame you for not doing it, remember? But now, there's a big problem. A lot of people are dropping all kinds of problems from it. But it's even deeper than that. It changed everyone's DNA. Anyway, let's keep going. Now, remember this guy?
Well, I think it's finally safe to say. That guy you were on the train with, that was weird and smelled like beef tacos, he was right. Some of us are reptiles. That guy you went to that convenience store down in the south and he said,
I swear to God, them reptiles is real, I seen them.
He was also right. I'm here, baby. I ain't going nowhere.
There you go. Okay, we'll get rid of those guys now. And there we go. And then remember, who was involved in the trailer I'm going to show you? Just that guy right there. Now, you might remember this. I did videos on this. I have this exact footage in other videos. You might want to go back and watch them on Collect Files. Like I said, I pretty much feel like I did my job. I'm just reiterating some points, like how stupid obvious is it now? Everything I've been telling you, how stupid obvious is it? It's not even obvious. It's stupid obvious. Vatican's a snake.
Pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario. Pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario of a comprehensive cyber attack, which would bring to a complete halt to the power supply, transportation, hospital services, our society as a whole. The COVID-19 crisis would be seen in this respect as a small disturbance in comparison to a major cyber attack.
The World Economic Forum, it's actually doing, remember with COVID, they had Event 201,
right,
where they were simulating these coronaviruses.
It turns out to be the pandemic that came just a few weeks later.
Exactly. Well, the WEF is doing the same thing for cyber attacks. And this is the headline here when they started doing it. Prepping for a cyber pandemic, worldwide drill underway. It says the World Economic Forum kicked off its annual cyber polygon exercise Friday, which gives companies and governments the opportunity to participate in a simulation of a cyber pandemic. And then about a year ago, the WEF puts out a press release and starts to really put a fine point on timelines here. Geopolitical instability raises threat of catastrophic cyber attack in the next 2 years. So now we have a big timeline. And then we start seeing governments start to talk about this. So this was last year, 2022. Biden releases Russian cyber attack warning to all Americans. Here it is. So Biden's talking about that. And then just last week here in the UK, UK could be brought to a halt at any moment by cyber attack, report warns. The Obamas produce movie about cyber attack called Leave the World Behind. And if you haven't seen it, here's a clip from that show. Take a listen.
Because my primary client works in the defense sector, I spent a lot of time studying the cost-benefit analysis of military campaigns. There was one program in particular that terrified my client the most. A simple three-stage maneuver that could topple a country's government from within. The first stage was isolation. Disable their communication and transportation. Make the target as deaf, dumb, and paralyzed as possible. Setting them up for the second stage. Synchronized chaos. Terrorize them with covert attacks and misinformation. Overwhelming their defense capabilities, leaving their weapon systems vulnerable to extremists in their own military. Without a clear enemy or motive, people would start turning on each other. Done successfully, the third stage would happen on its own.
What's the third stage?
A coup d'etat. Civil war. Collapse.
Well, the migrant crisis is about to get even worse, if you can believe.
So now I'd like to share something else with you. I live in Texas and we've seen, man, the people on the streets are so noticeable now. It's crazy in San Antonio. There are certain streets in San Antonio that are very close to where I live. And you can drive over there and you can see the migrants. They're just taking over from behind buildings and just they have nowhere to go. And I feel sorry for them. They're over at CPS, City Public Service, and they're giving them all phones. I went by there and watched. They're just handing out phones to them. And looks like they're signing them up somehow in some capacity for maybe service, you know, I don't know, but there's a whole lot of people being processed. So here's the interesting thing. They found bracelets on piles of bracelets, you know, the little rubber bracelets like you get when you go to a concert. You know what's on those bracelets? I have them in a folder. It has the head of the devil, like a circle with horns and like a smiley face. And the head of the devil is rotating, and it's like rotating in a circle, like turning upside down. And it says entrega. Entrega, like arriving. The devil is arriving and it's rotating. You know, you remember that song Alicia Keys sang? Obama's going to set the world on fire. He's got both feet on the ground and he's burning it down. Anyway, just thoughts, just stuff. Now, let me show you this. So I'm just going to show you a couple things. This is one of the paintings done by Kehinde Wiley. You know, those are all sperm all over the painting, right? Let me see if I have a little clip here for you. Maybe I do. I don't know. Is it me or can y'all see that sperm right there? Or is it me or is that just the big head of a sperm with its coming down and its tail going down here? Again, I just want to tie together who I want you to have a be able to see the faces. Noble Harari and the words, because it's the words. If I saw, you know, Corey standing next to Noble Harari, I would say, that's weird. Why was he standing over there? But until I heard the words out of someone's mouth, I wouldn't make a determination about them. But now their own words speak for themselves. So the point I'm trying to make is a lot of people judge people by saying, oh, I saw someone standing next to someone. That's not an accurate representation to judge somebody. When you hear their words are important. Words are very important. So listen to these words. Please listen to all these words.
We humans should get used to the idea that we are no longer mysterious souls. We humans should get used to the idea that we are no longer mysterious souls. We are now hackable animals. All of life was subject to the laws of natural selection and to the laws of organic biochemistry. But this is now about to change. Science is replacing evolution by natural selection with evolution by intelligent design. Not the intelligent design of some god above the clouds, but our intelligent design. And at the same time, science may enable life after being confined for 4 billion years to the limited realm of organic compounds. Science may enable life to break out into the inorganic realm. So after 4 billion years of organic life shaped by natural selection, we are entering the era of inorganic life shaped by intelligent design.
It's a need for a great reset. So people assume we are just going back to the good old world, which...
I want to pause it. Can you imagine that in a video where they're talking about a great reset to show an upside down image of somebody? Do you think that's weird? Well, what about the person that's speaking to you is the one that the Lord God, whom I serve, showed me that you were inverted. So, and if that bothers someone that I said that the Lord had me show the world, I serve the living God. I'm bragging about him. He's the one that did it all. I didn't do anything except say yes to going through a door and willing to die to go through it. So there you go. Anyway, here we go. Let's watch that again.
Is replacing evolution by natural selection with evolution by intelligent design. Not the intelligent design of some god above the clouds, but our intelligent design. And at the same time, science may enable life after being confined for 4 billion years to the limited realm of organic compounds. Science may enable life to break out into the inorganic realm. So after 4 billion years of organic life shaped by natural selection, we are entering the era of inorganic life shaped by intelligent design.
It's a need for a great reset. So people assume we are just going back to the good old world which we had and everything will be normal again. This is, let's say, fiction. It will not happen.
There is only one way this pandemic is going to go. It's going to get worse and worse and worse.
Pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario of a comprehensive cyber attack, which would bring to a complete halt to the power supply, transportation, hospital services, our society as a whole. The COVID-19 crisis would be seen in this respect as a small disturbance in comparison to a major cyber attack.
Speaking of things I can't unsee, I keep seeing these videos of Klaus Schwab from the World Economic Forum all over, you know, mostly on Twitter, but all over the online world. You don't see them ever on mainstream media. And the World Economic Forum is basically this group, this globalist group that is putting leaders in all of our countries. Justin Trudeau was one of their young protégés. Here's a video from Klaus Schwab at the World Economic Forum.
Waves of lockdowns and the stresses of finding work or returning to workplaces have even amplified the existential and often silent mental health crisis. So, what should you do? You are calling for the international community to safeguard vaccine equity, to respond to COVID-19 and prevent future health crises. Nobody will be safe if not everybody is vaccinated.
Did you hear what that psychopath said? Did you hear what he said? That you are calling on the international community to safeguard vaccine equity, meaning if one person gets it, everybody has it. That's what he's saying. Just don't make no mistake about it. Those are exactly the words he used, just different nomenclature. No one is safe unless everyone is vaccinated. Why are you all so intent on that? Did I show you the guy walking down the street? Hey, we're here to stay. That dude that looked like a raptor. Y'all figuring this out now? Remember the guy that showed everybody the Vatican was a snake? Remember that guy? Yeah. Anyway, it's a tough pill to swallow, but it's all true, isn't it? Holy moly. So now you got a guy that has a presidential portrait, and he's a big lizard in his portrait. He's also the serpent in the garden in his portrait. He's also got a dead sheep in his portrait. So let's see. You got a T-Rex. You know what? Let me pull up a folder just so I can show it to you. Let's just do that. So just while I was hunting for my picture, just thought I'd show you this one real quick. That's just a little bit enhanced. That's like a big sperm right there. And then there's a smaller sperm going the other direction. And then his hair was obviously way too 3D. And if you just look carefully, it's a serpent eating a smaller sperm. So why is there a serpent in the side of his head eating a smaller sperm? Why is there a giant head of a sperm on his forehead that turns into the fang of a serpent? That's kind of crazy. Let's see. Hang on one sec. So now here's one of Kehinde Wiley's other paintings with sperm in it. There it is. And so he's the same guy that did the Obama portrait, and he did an interview where he said, I put sperm in my paintings to mock male energy. He just said it in different words. He says, I like to put sperm in my paintings to like reduce that machismo, that to take little shots at masculinity. Those are his words. That basically means to take shots at masculinity, mean male energy, our God from heaven. And so that's what this is all about. That's what the whole thing's all about. So let me see if I can find that clip real quick. Anyway, folks, if you guys want to go to this folder, just watch this real quick. I just want y'all to see what's coming. If you can't figure out how stupid obvious this is now, the Vatican's a snake eating a bunch of angels. That's what it is. The presidential portrait is a snake. He's a snake in the garden. And there's a dead sheep, just like the Vatican has dead sheep as angels. And a snake's eating those angels. What about Obama being a snake with a dead sheep on one side of his head and a T-Rex on the other side of his head? I mean, does that make any difference in y'all's world? I know it does in mine. Okay, ready? Let's watch this. Here we go. Let's just watch this.
A different perspective on the man on the street. You need only look at the works of a rising young painter, as our Rita Braver has been doing.
If you look at all of the paintings that I love in art history, these are the paintings where
a rising young painter, as our Rita Braver has been doing.
I want you to notice how they started this scene where they walked him around a corner with an angel. They walked him around the corner. So this had to be edited. Why'd they start the whole thing with an angel with its head cut off? You know, the Vatican's a snake eating angels. I mean, why'd they start the whole segment with an angel with its head cut off?
If you look at all of the paintings that I love in art history, these are the paintings where great, powerful men are being celebrated on the big walls of museums throughout the world. What feels really strange is not to be able to see a reflection of myself in that world.
So the New York-based Kehinde Wiley set out to create a new paradigm. Men of color in street dress, painted in classical style, often echoing masterworks. The images are considered so hip, they've even been used as a backdrop in the Fox series Empire.
Kehinde Wiley.
Yes, indeed.
And with paintings selling for as much as $400,000, the work is considered important enough that though he is only 38, a survey of his career is now on view at the Modern Art Museum of Fort Worth after opening at the Brooklyn Museum.
His work has a broad appeal to high art culture mavens, as well as to people who don't know anything about art but are taken by his references to hip-hop and to street culture.
But Eugenie Tsai, who curated the exhibit in Brooklyn, says that beyond their social statements, the paintings have undeniable artistic merit, as in Wiley's version of St. Andrew.
There's so many ways you could read the face of this young man. Deliberate, do you think?
I do think it's deliberate. I think one of the...
I'm going to pause it for a sec because I'm just going to save you guys some watching torture. Here you go.
As a learning experience.
You can't allow that to be what dictates your work. You simply have to say that they're talking about me.
And he can be mischievous. Take a close look at Napoleon leading the army across the Alps.
In small ways, I'm taking little jabs at the masculinity, the bravado. Even with the fact that there's sperm cells, all of this, taking this masculinity down to its most essential component.
Then there are...
Okay, so there you go. He just said it, and I just showed you. I just showed you Barack Obama with two sperm on his forehead, and Kehinde Wiley's the one that painted the painting, so it's obvious they're sperm, and he put them there on purpose. But the sperm, the big one, is the fang of a serpent in the garden. So that would suggest that the guy that's the Tyrannosaurus Rex in the presidential portrait that's telling Joe Biden what to do is the incarnation of a tyrant lizard king. That's what it would suggest. Let's just be honest. I mean, there you go. Okay, so and there's his, that's what he thinks about all of us. And there's proof about his painting, Kehinde Wiley. I just showed it to you. And now, let's go to the folder. So then you have to ask yourself, is that a sperm in his... on the side of his head right there? Is this a larger one? So it's a yes or no answer. And then, is the side of his head that his hair a serpent eating a smaller sperm? Well, that's what the whole serpent race is doing. It's eating a smaller, it's eating an angelic race. I will arise above the stars of El. Now, what do you think you're seeing now? See, the Lord gave me the ability to see through their veil, and I can see it all now. I can see their whole thing. There's their serpent eating a smaller sperm, and the serpent's mouth and the fang is simply a sperm, because that's what the serpent bite was, is a sperm. And if you just simply pay attention, the whole thing's the head of a serpent right there. But also, he's got a T-Rex on the side of his head as well. And so it's become painfully obvious now because the Lord's let me draw it all in. So then it's just a yes or no answer. Is that a T-Rex just cleverly hidden in the painting? Because then if it is, then you should know where we're at in human history. That would be the guy that's going to house the spiritual essence of the pit. Because tyrant lizard king, they had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit. So if the angel of the bottomless pit has to occupy a host body, is it reasonable to say that it's that guy that's in the shape of the serpent from the garden? Because he's the serpent from the garden in his painting. So anyway, so that would suggest that all these people at the World Economic Forum, Klaus Schwab and Noel Harari, that they would be vocalizing what their plans for you are. First of all, you're an animal. You're a hackable animal. Anything you think about God is a joke. It's fiction to them. And for you to think that you have any human rights in their eyes is absolutely ludicrous, because that's just some human construct. It's not some God-given right, because according to them, there is no God, and you're a nut or for believing in fiction. Why is the Vatican a snake? Yeah. So now, hopefully you see where we're at in human history, right? I want to make sure that you guys watch the little short clip of Jean-Pierre, you know, whatever her name is. I can't listen to her. When her lips are moving, she's lying. It's repugnant to watch her just stand there and lie. Now, don't forget, she even referred to that she likes working for President Obama. She said it. Jen Psaki, the previous secretary, Biden's press secretary, said the same thing. President Obama, they both said they're working for President Obama in Freudian slips. So it's obvious that who's calling the shots and where we're at now in the world, because that Islamic Jihad is taking over from the inside of everything, all countries, everywhere. And that's what's going on in the world. That's in the Bible, the word rise, if you look at the word, it's Allah, to rise, Allah. They're rising from the depths, Allah, to take those sheeple down. So that's where we're at. I hope that all made sense to you guys. It's just the most stupid, obvious thing in the world now. Anyway, and I just wanted to make sure that I just put it out there over and over again for you guys to see it. Oh, that's right. So we have a friend that was, by the grace of God, set free of his abductor and his kidnapper, and he had opened the door and let him into his life, and he's going to give you a testimony about it, about how he messed up and let this person into his life, and how this person mentally worked his brain and was kidnapping him and on the way to probably, well, he had already just told him what was going to happen to him, and I'll let Richard tell you the story. But he's still in a world where he's got to deal with the fallout from divorce stuff and what happened with this lunatic Pesca taking over all his stuff. And so we're trying to make sure he doesn't get under their thumb by them putting him in a precarious position where he can't afford to make some payments that he's required to make in order not to let them have the ability to put him in jail. Anyway, so that's where we're at. I've been helping a plethora of folks during these holidays. It's been overwhelming. A lot of people have needed help, and we got to do what we got to do. Anyway, so, all right, I love you in Christ. I'm going to show you how, if you want to help us, and then I'm going to show you the link that I'm going to put to the press secretary assuring us that Barack Obama is not the one running things, okay? But you got to go click on it yourself. I want to put it in the video, but I don't want it to be a cause for a problem in the video. So, okay, so just a sec. Hang on. So one way you can help us, just help others, is you can PayPal to jk@jonathankleck.com, or we have a P.O. Box. Yep, so if you can step up, guys, that would be awesome. P.O. Box 91281, San Antonio, Texas, 78209, or you can PayPal to jk@jonathankleck.com. Anyway, that's it. If you want to help, that would be awesome. If you just... thanks for all the help anyway in the past, guys. Now, back to this. I wonder what the odds are that they line these names up and it says Bail. Well, it would suggest that Bail is exactly who this guy serves, because the serpent is part of his freaking presidential portrait, which is weird. I mean, he didn't do the portrait. True, but all you have to do is you'll tell every tree by its fruit. And just look at the fruit. And now, let's see, here's The John Pierre thing, hang on. If you want to see the John Pierre thing, you can go to the Las Vegas folder right here and go to the bottom of the links right here. So right here, I'm going to highlight this right here, and you'll see it right there. Okay, you see that? KJP trying to convince you Obama's not behind the Biden administration. Okay, I'm going to put that link below, but I'm not going to play it in this video. Okay, but I really hope you go watch it. It'll make you smile. All right, I love you in Christ, guys. Peace and grace. Yes, if we don't stand up and speak the truth, all you have that proves you're a free person is your voice and speaking the truth. The enemy's goal now in the end of the world is to censor and silence anyone that would be opposed to the authoritarian, draconian monsters that are going to take over the world in the end of the world. That's where we're at. And it should be very easy to see. I think Russell Brand did a really good segment talking about the way the establishment is coming for Twitter. So, you know, Elon Musk is Elon Musk, and God bless him and God have mercy on him. I see him standing up for people's rights, which is good for you. Of course, God wish he was converted. I'll leave that between him and the Lord God. But I see him standing up in places other people don't stand up. I'll say that about him. God bless him. And you know, but like I said, I would love to be able to say, you know, he's converted, but that's not something I could say. But anyway, God bless him for it standing up. If you want to hear Russell Brand give a very good explanation of what's going on with X and world, they're targeting Twitter worldwide now. They're going for it. And their goal is to have Twitter down by the summer. Just FYI. Okay, anyway, I love you guys in Christ. Let's get the bear hug out for the cult meeting. Okay, cult meeting, bear hug. Go get your bear hug. Okay, for the cult. Okay, there you go. I love you in Christ. I'm in the cult of Jesus Christ, being the Son of God, the only begotten Son of the Father, the male energy that came into the system that died on a cross in order to purchase you because you got mixed up in a twin female host body system that's reptilian that is now taking over the whole damn world. And it's easy to see. The Vatican's a snake, yes or no? End of story. Done. Okay, those people that think I'm bragging about me, you got it wrong. And as a matter of fact, if you were one of us, you would be rejoicing knowing that the Lord gave someone the ability to lay hands on people that are terminal and lay hands on people that are blind and they see. I give all the glory to the Lord God whom I serve. I'm not worthy to unlatch his sandals. But he chose me to do this probably because I could take a long extended beating and I'm tired. All right, I love you guys in Christ. Peace and grace. I'm going to be here, guys. Keep going. But again, all of y'all, throw the seed. Don't worry about what happens with it. Just throw it. If somebody comes and gets it, praise God. If they don't worry about it. God's in control. All right. Amen.